You have to understand that gay people in Chechnya, LGBT people in Chechnya, are a legitimate victim for Chechen police, for Chechen authorities. And since 2017, when we broke the story, the detainees and torture of those people never stopped, and even the murders. But at the end of this year, last year, and the beginning of this year, we began to receive a lot of information about the massive detainees of people, like you said, and I can confirm this information. More than 40 people were detained, tortured, and I can confirm at least one death of a gay person who was detained and tortured to death. The difference between the situation that happened in the 2017 is that back then it was sort of ideological persecution of the gay people in Chechnya, and Ramzan Kadyrov, the leader of Chechnya, many times publicly said that it was a clearness of Chechen blood from those people. They shouldn't exist among the Chechen society. They should be killed. And this time, it looks like there was no such kind of order from the Chechen authorities, and it was the initiative of Chechen police who used those people as a source of getting money. They blackmailing them, they threatened them that they will open the information about their sexual orientation, and they wanted to receive money from them. But then, when they were detaining people, they suddenly, not suddenly, but they detained a person who had a group in a social network, a Russian social network, ВКонтакте, and that guy actually gave a lot of contacts of other gays and other LGBT people, among them also women, to the police, and that's why we are dealing now with the massive detention of those people, torturing them, and those people in danger. The problem is that people in Chechnya, the LGBT people in Chechnya, didn't learn lessons from the previous campaign. They behave not accurately. They continue to use internet and messengers and the phones to communicate with each other, and they're not secure with this. And when the threat is really high and their close contacts are detained and even killed, they still stay in Chechnya.
Ms. Benishir, sorry to interrupt you. I just want to pick up on something you said, that according to your sources, according to your reports, it's the police that are involved in this. If it is the police that are carrying out this, is there any recourse for those activists or of the alleged victims to turn to someone higher up the chain, to appeal to authorities higher up, or will that fall on deaf ears?
No. Deaf ears? No. The situation is in Chechnya is it's very terrible, because a lot of people in Chechnya are detained constantly and tortured by Chechen police, and the police has kind of a carte blanche to do this from the federal center, from the Moscow, and it's not possible to bring them to the justice, and that's the main problem. That we can make our investigative committee open the criminal case and punish the Chechen policemen or Absolutely. The Chechen authorities who gave this order. So that's why it's continuing, and it Yes. will be continued.